class, we are going to learn how to do pulse for state competency now. So I really don't need any supplies other than my fingers for this skill. So I'm going to go ahead and knock. I've already introduced myself to my patient. I tell Mr. Smith that I'm going to be checking his pulse now. So for me, I'm going to go ahead and raise the bed up because I don't like to work over a low bed. Kills my back. So I'm going to bring him up to a nice comfortable height for me. If you're doing this skill for state competency, and this is one skill, believe it or not, that more people have problems with. It's kind of interesting. I think more people have problems with pulse than they do with blood pressure. I do not need to pull the privacy curtain again because I'm really not overexposing them, but I'm going to go ahead and bring his arms out, or ask him to bring his arms out. Now what's going to happen is I'm going to be checking on one side for the pulse and the evaluator is going to be checking on the other side. Now, you have the option, you can actually check both sides and see if there's one side that you feel it better, and you can take that side, okay? That's up to you. So I like to just check both pulses myself just to make sure they feel the same. If one side feels stronger to me than the other, then that's the side I want to do. When I'm finding the pulse, don't be surprised if you get the skill for state competency if your evaluator brings a towel over. And when you're finding your pulse on your side, the evaluator will put a towel over to find it on their side. They are not supposed to give you a hint as to where to find it on your side. So some evaluators do that and some don't. So don't be surprised or alarmed if they're covering up, you know, with the towel when you're checking pulses. So I'm finding the pulse, and with your pulse, you're going to be looking at the radial artery, which is on the thumb side, and it's usually right here in the groove. I like to find the person's kind of the bony part of their wrist right here, and then I just roll right over that area. You can play with this to see what's more comfortable for you. I see some people check pulses on the pads of their fingers. I usually feel it better on the tips of my fingers, but you can figure that part out for yourself. So I'm going to find that area where the pulse is, and I'm going to use 2 to 3 fingers, never your thumb. Your thumb can generate its own pulse. The person's arm should be relaxed. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to count my pulse. Now you are required for this skill to use a second hand, a watch with a second hand. You cannot use a digital watch. You are not allowed for state competency to use a smartwatch. So you have to have a watch with a second hand. So I'm going to find that area and I'm going to make sure my evaluator is ready on her side. And then I'm going to look at my watch, and I usually like to wait until I'm at the 12 or at the 6, you know, a really easy number for me to remember, you know, when I got started, so I can make sure I stop in the correct place. Now, normally when you're doing vital signs, you would check for a pulse for 30 seconds and then multiply by 2 unless it was irregular. But for state competency, you're required to check it for 1 full minute. One thing I do not recommend is watching your watch the whole time, because as that second hand's going around and you're watching it, sometimes you start counting 1, 2 as it's going around instead of actually counting what you're feeling. So the other thing I like to do, or the other thing I really recommend for state competency, is when you're ready to start. So if I tell my evaluator, okay, we're gonna start on the 3, or I'm gonna start on the 6, when I get to that 6, I'm gonna do 1, 2, 3. I'm going to count the first 3 out loud. It automatically puts the evaluator and you on the same pace. Because sometimes when you say, okay, I'm going to start now, and then did you count that one and they waited till the next one, you're already off by 1. So sometimes the start and the stop, you can already be off by a point. So I recommend to my students just saying, okay, we're going to start on the 3 and 1, 2, 3, and then I'll just start counting quietly. I generally do not, like I said, I don't look at my watch. I kind of look off. Sometimes I'll even just close my eyes. But when I know I'm getting close to that minute area, or when I'm getting closer to that time, then I'll look back down to my watch to make sure I know when I'm stopping. And so when I count for that full minute, and now I'm coming up to my starting point, and I'll say, okay, stop. And now you and your evaluator are both gonna stop. So now, before you record your results, you have to put the rail up, put the bed down, give the person their call light, I'm going to tell my evaluator I would wash my hands, and then I'm allowed to record. Now on that recording sheet, you would grab it one real quick. On the recording sheet here, you will have your name and your ID on it. You're going to mark radial pulse. You're required to do the radial pulse. You'll mark it, candid is you. You're gonna put how many you got. Normal heart rate is 60 to 100 beats per minute, but you may have someone who's fast or someone who's slow. So you're gonna write in what you got, and then you're gonna hand it to your evaluator, and they're gonna write what they got. They will not tell you if you are correct or not. Now for state competency, you're allowed to be off four beats from your evaluator. So you can always recheck. If you aren't sure that you caught all of them, you can just say, hey, I wanna recount it, and you can always recount it and double check yourself if you want. And that completes that skill.